What is up, everybody? My name is iRocky, and today I'm going to be showing you guys how to make the new best center build in NBA 2K20.
I've been ballin' so damn hard, I swear I think that I'm Kobe. Young bull on this rap shit, but I think that I'm Kobe. I swear I'm dunkin' on these hoes, on these niggas, I'm free throwin'. These boys, they don't like me, cause I think that I'm Kobe. Watch me hit the strip.
So obviously you're gonna wanna make him a center. Handedness and jersey number is preference, doesn't matter which one you choose. Then you're going to want to choose the pure red pie chart. As you can see, it is the very last one. So, and then physical profile, it doesn't really matter, all of them are good options, but I went with the balanced at the, once again, the very bottom, because all of your stats are very solid. And then you're going to want to max out everything in finishing, and then go down to defense and rebounds and max out everything there as well. And then you'll have 30, and then you can just put that wherever you want, but I'm putting it on 3-point and mid-range so I can shoot a little bit. And then make him 6'9". This might be a little surprising because you might say, oh, that's way too short to be a center. Still 90 strength, still insane defense, and when you make him 6'9", look at the perimeter, lateral, and steal. You can guard point guards on this build, as well as having 75 speed. This is a center where you can guard any position you want. So then for weight, I went with 247 because it gets the strength back up to 95, only takes down Excel and vertical a little bit, and then gives you that +3 boost in interior defense while only taking down lateral quickness down by 1. And then wingspan, you could go with max wingspan, but that does take your strength down a lot and only gives you +3 in steel. So I went with 88.8, which is 3 ticks down. Wait. No, sorry. I went with 87.8, which gives me a +2 steel, and then only -1 to 94 strength, which will still be able to max out to 99 strength if you get to 99. And then takeover, doesn't matter at all. Both of them are very effective, but I prefer rim protector because it's easier to get, and it's you just dominate. Like, no one's gonna score in your paint when you have rim protector. So yeah, there you have it. Paint beast, similar to Ben Wallace, Andre Drummond, Dwight Howard, which is really all you want for this build. Just lock up the paint. Even though you're 6'9", trust me, no one's scoring on you if you have the right badges, and you're good at the game, obviously. So yeah, and then now I'm gonna show you guys the best badges to use for this build. So as you guys can see, there's a pretty good badge spread on this build. The only thing I don't like is that you don't get Hall of Fame finishing, but that doesn't really matter with your great finishing stats. So we're going to go over, put Fancy Footwork on gold, Contact Finisher on gold, Slithery Finisher on gold, Acrobat on gold, Lob City on silver, and Giant Slayer on silver. And then shooting does not matter, but I will say, if you watch Jono's video, I believe it was called The Power of 47 3-point in NBA 2K20, I'm pretty sure that's what it was called, you can hit these shots if you have either you're on takeover and you have a point guard with either Dimer or which one is it, Floor General. You can actually hit shots from the corner, so that's why I put on catch and shoot, because it boosts your percentage with catch and shoots. And then, or if you're on takeover as well as a point guard that's on takeover with playmaking takeover. Jeez, I just said takeover like 5 million times. So anyway, if you're in that scenario, you can also hit jump shots. So I just have catch and shoot. But obviously, you don't want to shoot very much with this build, because it is not a shooting build, I'm telling you that right now. And then on playmaking, you either want quick first step or unpluckable on bronze, because you will be able to take the ball up the court since you're very fast. And then, yeah, I just chose unpluckable. Then moving on to the big badges, the defense and rebounding 30 potential upgrades. Put on Hall of Fame box, Hall of Fame brick wall, Hall of Fame intimidator, Hall of Fame clamps, gold moving truck, gold post move lockdown, and then Hall of Fame rim, Hall of Fame rebound chaser. That is what I prefer to use. You could also take down post move lockdown and put on pogo stick, or take down either of those and put that on chase down artist, but that's what I like to use. Oops. And so this is what I like to use. As you can see, extremely great badges. You will be able to guard anyone in the post. You will not get bullied. So if you're hesitant about that, about getting bullied in the paint, do not worry, because your height does not matter if you have 30 badges. So so that's it, gonna be it for the video. If you liked it, if you found it helpful, please drop a subscribe. I'm doing a $10 giveaway at 100 subscribers. It's completely free, so if you want to enter that, please help me get there. We're only 27 away at the time of this recording, so please help me get there. And yeah, I'll be doing a free $10 giveaway, and thanks for watching.